took your time.
Now, sexy?
Sexy? Whose is it?
Mine, of course. I got it for my birthday.
It's not your birthday. Must have cost all of what, 8,000 guilders?
10.
10?
I admit I did anticipate my birthday a bit.
You've got a lover, have you, or a sugar daddy?
Pete. You sound half serious.
I think I'm wholly serious.
Well, thanks for the compliment, darling.
It's a compliment.
Oh, yes. Feel it.
I don't have to feel it. I know it's the real thing.
No. Feel it.
You sensual animal, you.
Are you complaining?
No, but...
But what?
Well, after the new bathroom, I don't think I can quite afford a 10,000 guilder coat. Not this month.
You idiot.
Yeah, I'm an idiot.
And beautifully teasable. Here.
Exquisite Russian blue fox jacket. Never been worn. Value 10,000 guilders. Bargain price 3,000. Hoffman, 195890.
I couldn't afford not to buy it, could I? I went round to see it this afternoon. Darling, you're not really cross, are you?
Yes, it's a bargain, all right. It's too good to be true. 10 to 1, that came off the back of a lorry.
I must confess, I did have a tiny voice echoing at the back of my head.
And you ignored it. Yes, everybody does it.
Oh, you make me feel awful. I'll take it back.
Come here. No. Don't take it off.
Madame Hoffman speaking.
Ah, yes, I'm ringing about the fur. Has it gone yet?
No, the coat hasn't been sold.
That's good news. Now, could I pop round and see it then, about 11?
What was the name, please?
Becker. Pete Becker.
Nothing skimpy, you see, Mr. Becker. Full, generous. Nothing worse than a skimpy fur.
Nothing worse, no. You show it off very well.
Thank you. I was a model.
Ah?
For a while. Long time ago now, though.
You've lost none of your style.
It is a genuine bargain. An absolute sacrifice.
Well, I know nothing about furs, but even I can tell that. How can you afford to let it go at this price?
It was a gift.
A gift?
I need the cash.
Mm. Well, forgive me, I'm a bit slow this morning, you know. Sort of difficult to make up a mind.
Take your time, Mr. Becker. Take your time.
Well, the fact is, I'm a bit hungover, actually. Do you have,
Hair of the dog?
Well, it's disgraceful, isn't it? Do you have any scotch?
Certainly, and you have my sympathy.
Ah. Well, you're an understanding woman. Not many about.
Oh, I imagine you've found a few, Mr. Becker.
Are you flattering me, Madame Hoffman?
Possibly. I must warn you that someone else is due in about 10 minutes.
Oh, to see the coat? I wonder if I might have some ice in that. Nuisance, aren't I? Thanks.
It's only a reproduction, you know.
Good, though.
So you didn't arrest her?
No, I didn't give her a clue either.
I suppose there is a method in this seeming madness.
Look, she's small time. Hijacking, raids on warehouses, department stores, it's gone up 85% in the last 6 months.
But why didn't you arrest her?
Because it all points to organization. There's an organizer. He fixes the rip-offs and can place the goods.
So you're suggesting that this Hoffman woman could lead us to the organizer?
Possibly.
Well, that's not very explicit.
She's a tip of a tentacle. She's one of the people who takes all the risks, while somewhere in the middle there's a Mr. Big who takes all the cash. He's the one we should be after.
I see. Well, what are you going to do about her?
First, put her under the microscope. I think we can forget the others, but this one looks interesting. Who's he?
Schultz. Nick Schultz.
Never heard of him.
He got 4 years and 68 in possession of stolen goods. Mm-hmm. Wristwatches, assorted jewelry and silverware. He's been clean, though, for quite a while.
He looks sharp to me. I'll bet he's still bent.
Yes, I'd say you're pretty safe there. So you want to start with him, then?
With your permission, yes.
It could take a long time.
If we pull it off, it'll be worth it.
And if you don't, you could end up in the canal.
No, thanks. I've given them up.
What?
Well, almost. Look, I thought I'd call myself Besson, Pete Besson. Easy enough to remember?
Mm-hmm. Where are you going to stay?
I thought the Victoria's about right.
Mm-hmm.
I'll book in tomorrow. Don't worry. I'll keep in touch.
Damn that coat.
Oh, come on. Won't be for long.
That's a lie.
Well, this isn't like you.
It's not like you either.
What isn't?
Playing at being a crook.
That's a very different from playing at being a cop, when you come to think about it. Hmm?
Oh, I'm sorry. What's this?
Ah, my samples. Hmm?
Do they fall off the back of a lorry as well?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, what do you think of this? I think I ought to be a snappy dresser for this joint, don't you?
In that case, you better take your bow tie.
Yes, great ideas.
Yes?
Mr. Besson?
Yes, Pete Besson speaking.
I thought you'd like to know that your friend's drinking at the bar John John.
How long's he been there?
About 10 minutes. Looks fairly settled. Okay?
Okay. Thanks.
Is your room comfortable, Mr. Besson?
Yes, it is. Thank you very much.
Your pleasure, sir.
Oh, I'm afraid we can't go into that just now, darling, but pills will be enough to go on with.
That's modest enough, dear. There we are, dear.
Guy at the end reading the newspaper. Is he Nick Schultz? What's he drinking?
Same as you are, dear.
I'll have another, please. Thanks. How's it going, Nick? Pete Besson, friend of Johnny's? Johnny Levesque. Yeah, he said I'd find you here. Prost.
I don't know any, Levesque.
Well, that's funny. He knows you. Told me you were a man of taste. A guy who could appreciate a good thing when he saw it.
Get lost. Hmm?
Nick, I understand your attitude. I mean, in your position, I'd be the same. But I think I would ask myself a couple of questions before I said get lost. A question doesn't cost anything, but the answer could be profitable. Now, listen. How much are you going to have to pay for a watch like that? 600 guilders. I know a fella who could supply the same article for 120. Now, would you agree that's an answer that is profitable? So don't commit yourself now. I mean, think about it. Look, I'm staying at the Victoria Hotel, room 416. Why don't you call me, or better still, drop by. And, so keep the watch. Present. Yeah, Pete. 3 days and there's been nothing.
I don't think they're going to take the bait.
There could be better than a 50-50 chance. Anyway, you give it a week. There's still time.
Well, I'll give it 3 days more and that's all, okay? Bye. Time, he says. Any messages for me, please?
No, Mr. Besson, nothing.
Thank you.
What the hell?
Young and ever, please, love.
Like that, is it, dear?
Yeah. Nice way to check me out, Nick.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No? Well, your boys have really screwed things up somewhat. You want to know why? I was prepared to do a deal in diamonds. That's right, a lot of diamonds. What a pity.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No, you said that before. Well, you and your boys can go and get lost. Oh, I'm sorry I didn't buy you a drink this time, but you can share mine. And don't you ring me, Nick, because I won't ring you.
Talking about diamonds. Thank you.
It's all over then?
I'm afraid it's only just beginning.
Why are you so pale?
Am I? Oh, just a bit of a headache, that's all.
I'll get you an aspirin.
Actually, I prefer a glass of white wine if we've got one. Yeah, that smells good, but.
Why are you limping?
Oh, what is this?
3-day-old ragu. Would you like some?
Will it stretch?
Oh, I'm sick to death of it. I'll have an omelette. Look, why are you limping?
Of course, hot. Good, though. You know what, darling? I missed your cooking. You too, of course.
You really are impossible.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. Were you in a fight or something?
Of course not.
Then why are you limping?
Oh, it's too ridiculous.
Well, try me.
Well, I ran into a girl.
You what?
It's all right. She was only 6 years old. I fell over her running for a tram.
Oh, come on, Pete.
I told you it was bloody ridiculous.
Now where are you going?
Oh, just to slip into something loose. Love you.
Love you too.
Pete?
What?
Do you want potatoes?
Yes, I'll have a couple of potatoes.
Well, you've been a long time.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's after 10 o'clock.
Really? There's more traffic comes through here than through the damn square. I don't know why I bothered to lock the door.
What's wrong with your leg? I thought it was your head.
Come on.
You are hurting my arm.
And I am throwing you out.
But we have to talk.
I don't want to talk.
Business talk.
Hmm?
Money talk.
Did your boyfriend send you here to pacify me?
Boyfriend?
Nick Schultz.
He's not my boyfriend. And he doesn't send me anywhere.
Oh, I see.
Thank you. Don't worry. It isn't lethal. I'm interested.
Why don't you just get lost?
How much time are we going to waste? Look, I'm sorry. I said I'm sorry for what happened, all right?
All right.
So when can you make the delivery?
It's a question of arranging the border crossing. Let's say between week and 10 days.
Fair enough.
You have the authority for this. It's a deal.
It's a deal. Now about your diamonds.
2 million. 2 million guilders. Are you sure?
That's what he said. Valued on the open market, anyway.
Well, you've obviously taken it seriously. Or you wouldn't have bothered me here.
Sure, it's for real. I've got this feeling about it.
In which case, I shall have to carry out further investigations, won't I? Riker was most impressed by you. I can see why. Oh, can you? Of course, you're a decisive, direct man who knows exactly what he wants. Now, that's a very attractive quality to most women. Is it? I don't think I'm any great authority on women. Oh, you're too modest. About your diamonds. Riker told me their value and a date in about 3 weeks' time, and then something about a courier coming into Amsterdam from Johannesburg. You told her nothing more, I believe. Is that so?
That's right. That's all I told her.
Well, the problem is, one really requires more information, Mr. Besson.
Here. Nice place you have here. You must have worked hard to get this.
Yes. Yes, of course.
You appreciate there's a lot at stake. I mean, that is what I told Malaika. I told her that I could only discuss details with the head of your organization.
Oh, I see, I see. And who do you think you're talking to now?
Well, I don't think I'm talking to the office boy.
You reassure me vastly.
So you reassure me?
I'll do anything that I'm able.
Am I speaking to the boss?
My dear Mr. Besson, you don't imagine you're talking to an employee. But look, I am not going to commit myself until you have proved yourself over the Omega contract.
Fair enough. He's not the boss.
Why not?
He isn't, that's all. We're going to go one higher.
Oh, come on, Pete, you're getting obsessive. What makes you so sure?
He comes on so strong. Real bosses don't have to do that. There's a problem, though.
Only one?
I'm going to need 1,000 Omega watches. Look, I have to fulfill that contract.
There's no way you're going to get them.
I thought you'd say that.
Maybe you've gone as high as you're going to get, Pete.
Look, I'm going to get to the top or not at all.
The longer you go on, the more likely it is that your cover will be blown.
So let's speed things up, then. Said he was
I want you to take a message to your employer. Tell her the diamond deal has been brought forward.
To when?
Just tell her.
The date's been brought forward, that's all he said.
Extraordinary, nothing more than that?
Nothing.
All right, Marika, thank you.
Oh, Mr. Besson.
What was this place? A brothel?
That is a correct observation, Mr. Besson.
I believe you wish to meet me.
Meet you and see you. I think you have an advantage.
That is another correct observation.
I'll make a third. Either we meet face to face or there's no business. And that includes the Omega deal.
I'm afraid I'm not prepared to be dictated to, Mr. Besson.
Neither am I. It's either head-to-head or nothing, damn it. There are 2 million at stake, and all the risks are on my side.
I don't see it entirely in that light.
Then you lose out.
We both lose out, Mr. Besson.
I'll give you till midday tomorrow to change your mind.
Hello?
Alec.
Speaking.
There's little wonder your friend Besson wanted to see me. I couldn't place him at first, but then it came to me. I was introduced to him briefly by Judge Gastron a couple of years ago. He's a commissaris in the Recherche. Real name of Vandervelde.
I see. What shall I do?
Kill him.
Yes. Yes, I'll arrange that.
Do you need any assistance, or can you handle it yourself?
I'll handle it myself.
No mistakes, Nick.
Better get back to bed, dear. You'll catch a death.
If anyone calls for me, I'll be back in an hour.
Yes, Mr. Wilson.
What do you think?
He's just killing time.
Better find a telephone.
Mr. Besson, he's changed his mind. He will see you. Oh, good. After you.
Do you have the heater on?
No, why? Are you too hot? Why didn't you open the window?
No, I'm not too hot. I was worrying about you.
very considerate. I mean, you don't look at all well.
Yes, that's better, a bit of fresh air. No, you don't look too fit to me. I mean, you getting enough exercise? I mean, all this expansive dining, it's all very well, you know, but it's not very good for the heart. See, I play a bit of golf. Golf is very good, you know, gets you out. Not too violent, but it pumps the old fresh air into you. Relaxation, that's the number one priority, right, in our business. You'd go along with that, wouldn't you? Wouldn't you, Eric? Go along with that?
Well, I do play golf. Badly, about twice a year.
Oh, that's no good. That's no good at all. I mean, it doesn't matter how well you play. It's getting out there. That's the important thing. Regularly. Although, of course, on the other hand, I suppose it doesn't matter at all. I mean, I've got a couple of friends. Well, I say friends, I mean acquaintances. Both died on the golf course.
Why don't you switch off the motor? He wants to see you alone. I'm simply following instructions.
Come on, you're setting me up.
Oh, don't be so stupid, Bessie. Oh. All right, all right. I'll come with you, but he won't like it.
So he won't like it?
It could jeopardize the deal, but it's up to you.
That's right. It's up to me.
Look, this is ridiculous. Shut up.
What's the point in delaying this business, Ehrlich, eh? What's the point? I can't make any promises, of course, but if you cooperate, it could help.
We don't care about you, Ehrlich. Not interested. It's the big man we want, you know that.
The public prosecutor will go easy on you if you cooperate.
On the other hand, if you don't.
Maximum sentence.
I don't think he can hear us, you know.
Are you listening?
Well, are you? All right. Come on, sit down.
You don't have to worry about the big man, you know. Once he's inside, we'll throw away the key.
Fine. Now then, let's start off with a little statement, shall we? Setup of the organization. We know it's international. Hamburg, Paris, Brussels, right?
He's a fellow countryman, isn't he? The boss.
Oh, come on, Ehrlich. You're not a hard nut. We all know that.
You find that amusing?
You feel the need to be expensive, do you? I'm afraid we don't have any oysters or chablis, but will a drop of scotch do?
Thank you, but no. Oh, you haven't lost your voice after all. I didn't think you were that stupid, Bundabug.
Stupid?
Yes. You know damn well there's no place you could put me if I talked where he wouldn't get to me. What's the maximum sentence? 10 years? Thank you. I'll serve it and come out alive.
So, he scares you that much, does he?
Yeah. Yes, that's right, Commissaris. That's absolutely right.
I can assure you, Ehrlich.
You can assure me all you like. Both of you. You can assure me for the rest of the day, for the rest of the month. But you will get a nil return out of me. A zero. Nothing. Do I make myself clear?
I think you're making a big mistake.
Yes, well, I'll have to take my chance on that.
Do you fancy your chances if we let you go?
Let me go?
Sure. Just let you walk out of here onto the street. Where you go?
You just stay where you are. Pete. What are you doing?
Well, he's not going to tell us, is he?
No, but at least we've got him here.
And we'll keep him here just long enough to organize a team to tail him, and then we're going to let him go. He's the sprat that's going to catch the mackerel.
But there's no guarantee that the big man will come out to get him.
Ehrlich is the only man who can identify him, so somehow he's got to shut him up. Anyway, what have we got to lose?
A lot if the high and mighty get onto it. It's highly irregular. You see, finally, I'm the one that has to carry the responsibility.
You could tell them that I went over your head.
I could. You know damn well I won't.
No, I suppose you won't. All right, it's up to you.
If the big man doesn't surface, what's
the
point?
We bring Ehrlich back in.
All right. Let's go for broke.
Are you sure you're feeling all right, darling?
Try. I'm sorry, I didn't catch what you said.
You haven't all evening.
I'm sorry.
Well, it's nice to have you back anyway.
Yes.
Sorry to call so late.
What time is it?
2:30, sir.
Well?
Well, I thought you ought to know. He's just wandering about. Where? Nowhere in particular. Just public places.
Well, he can't stay out forever.
Neither can we, sir.
Oh, yes, you can.
How long for?
For as long as it takes.
Ha 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 ha!